So this video is on critical points and critical numbers with regard to graphing by hand in calculus 1, or all through calculus, I guess. Let's get started. You press second alpha on your calculator, titanium. See this box here, which turns black, which shows you that you can enter letters. And the code for my menu, of course, is INDEX, and then you have to press alpha so you can get back to numbers and parentheses. You add 8 for both parentheses and you're into my menu. My menu has many, many things in it. Right now we're talking about critical points, so we're gonna go to critical points, pull up the program. And I tell you to mark on your paper right away, on your test paper or whatever, you know, a graph with these all labeled with numbers so you can mark down whatever comes up in my program, and then you can, you know, connect the dots and have your graph completed by hand. So we're going to enter a function from a test. I'm going to have to, for any of these boxes that come up in my program, you have to add alpha. You have to press alpha first, so we press alpha. And we're going to put in x cubed minus 6 times x squared plus 9 times x and plus 2. And then press enter twice. And I show you what you've entered in case you made a mistake. You can go back and do it. You press enter again. You can go OK or change it. I'm saying it's OK. My program's also, you can press the number before these, what your choice is. You can scroll down or and then press enter, but you can also just press the number and it'll go right to there. So we're at critical points. We want critical points in the menu. Instead of scrolling, we're going to just press 3 on the calculator. And I discuss critical points and numbers in a blog in my website, so check that out. Most tests come up with ask you for critical points, and there's a difference between critical numbers, critical points. And I discuss that. Here I put a little bit of information about it. Critical point really is an XY point on the graph, and critical numbers are on the x-axis, just what the X value is. However, professors and tests I've seen, you know, use both, and it's not correct. They're different. So, in critical numbers, you're gonna set the first derivative to 0, and then solve for x. So we factor the first derivative here, and we come up with the critical numbers, x equals 3 or x equals 1. That's what you'd put down. You put everything on your test just like this. You can't find the first derivative unless you put the function down. Then you find the first derivative and go from there. I find critical numbers and critical points on my program. So we take 3, one of the critical numbers of 3, and plug it into the first function, 3 cubed times minus 6 times 3 squared plus 9 times 3. And you write this on your paper and you come up with 2, y equals 2. So the first critical point is 3 and 2. Second one, you plug in 1 for a critical number into the primary function and come up with 6. So the second critical point is 1 and 6. And then it takes you back. You can find more parameters here. Press 1, you get more parameters and go whatever you want. Local, maximum, min, intervals of increase, decrease, inflection point, whatever you need to complete the graph on your test.